Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to my very first renovation component. Now, as you guys know, I've been doing a lot of 8-minute build challenges, and some of them haven't been coming out so well, coming out to a standard I would feel comfortable with. So, as you guys know, a lot of you voted on my polls, and we did do a renovation series as a kind of follow-up to the 8-minute architect. Now, for a lot of these builds, for the ones that I believe came out great and are functional, I'm probably not going to do too much to them. But today we are renovating the Pueblo House. This was one I was really excited for. yes, but I was really disappointed with the end result, to be honest with you guys. I didn't get to do any landscaping, and the lot wasn't even usable. I built this large platform in the front that you guys can see, and Sims just can't get in there. So hopefully we will try to tackle this build today. This will be a really chill series. If you guys are used to the 8-minute architect, it's super crazy busy, but we can just pretty much hang out, try to tackle this build, and maybe give it some new life. So with that said, we will jump right on in. It's very likely there will be some multiple parts, perhaps. I guess we're just gonna have to see how this goes. But anyways, I hope you guys are doing well. It is Tuesday, I believe. It is Tuesday, and yeah, the holidays are just right around the corner. So hopefully, if you guys do celebrate Christmas or celebrate any of the winter festivities, hopefully you guys have a lovely time. But yeah, let me see what we can do with this. I started this as some sort of little entryway here, so I'm gonna try and block that in. Some of you guys know that I just got the Jungle Adventures pack, so I think that could be really cool with this build. If you guys are not familiar with the Pueblo style houses, these were mainly seen in the desert. They were formed from a lot of the earth and clay that was from the desert itself, and I believe these were very common with the native peoples living in the southwestern United States. So I thought that was pretty interesting, and it definitely was a style I wanted to emulate. And you know, I think we can try to make this an off-grid build. I think that could be really cool. You know, like, you are really living out in the desert, you're kind of far away from all those nice utilities. Now, to be honest with you guys, I don't know if I could do it. I've never been camping before. So I don't think I would be able to do the whole off-grid living thing. I think I've been like too spoiled. I've been too spoiled by modern amenities, but yeah, we're gonna see how this goes. So looking at the front entrance, I did want to do something different for it. I think I wanted to create some kind of archway. So perhaps I can get rid of one of these windows and try to create a little bit of an enclosure here. I do have the half walls up there, and I definitely want to keep this a balcony. I really love having the outdoor space at the very top, and that was definitely something I was really sad about with this build. You guys know I was rushing. I made a very non-functional bedroom. It was kind of blocked off. And I never put any doors to the outside. There weren't any lounge chairs, so it was a pretty sad experience. But anyways, I'm thinking something like this. I think that could be super cool. I have these, but I think they are too low. Yeah, but let me see. I could make it higher, but I think it could be too tall. It's not bad. It's not bad, if I'm being honest with you guys. So maybe we can try one of these. Whoa, okay. That is too big, and oh god. You guys, if you are a Sims builder, you know very well the madness with moved objects on. You have doors, you have windows kind of glitching out, so let me get rid of those just to start, and then we can probably do something like this. I think this could be really cool. It definitely fits the feel, but the color is just a little bit off. But I don't mind it. I don't mind that. So we're gonna have a nice big entranceway here. Let me find some better doors, perhaps. And I don't really know what kind of doors are used in here. I assume they would be made out of wood. but maybe we can have a little pop of color. I think this one actually works great. As a quick note, if you guys want to work those color palettes in The Sims 4, and take this as a, I guess, maybe a tip from a graphic designer. I'm a graphic designer in my real job. But if you want colors to pop, if you choose complementary colors, those usually work very well. So because this is an orangey tan, this teal should fit pretty nicely there. Okay, so we are doing off-grid today. So let's see if we can find some good options for the lighting. I think the thing that really stinks about off-grid in The Sims 4 is that there aren't many options. I'm always using this little mason jar, and I think it's the only wall light that's gonna fit. Perhaps there are options in other packs, but yeah. Let me know what you guys think about that. There's just so little options in terms of off-grid stuff, which I think is a shame. I think it's a shame because it's a really interesting feature, and I would like to see more of it. But anyways, let's see if we can put some awnings on. There are a lot of really good options. I did get the Jungle Adventures pack, so we could do something like this. I think this is very fitting. It has kind of the, I believe this is a terracotta roof style, and this does resemble the one we have in the base game. But yeah, so we're gonna have a little bit of flair. We are going to stick with our 4-pack limit for this one. But anyways, let's see what we have for wood. Trying to match the tone a little bit. But yeah, I'm already liking that. I think it adds a nice layer of texture to the build. I'm gonna eyeball it, you guys. As you guys know, I don't use mods, so tool is pretty much out of the picture for now. And I think I will always keep it like that. I like building with what is in the game, and that's not to say that you can't use the tool mod, of course, but I think it adds a nice element to the challenge itself. And I know a lot of you also play on the console, so you don't really have the luxury of using mods. But anyways, here we are. Let me try to switch up this walkway. I don't think they made a really good match for this, because I'm trying to get that tile going. I'm trying to get it going, but I think this is as close as it's gonna get, which is not bad. It's not bad. Okay, so for the windows on the other sides, I don't know if I'm gonna keep all the windows the same. Let me see. We have this. I think my goal for today is to try and get at least a lot of the outside done, a lot of the shell. Because that's really what needed the dire fixing, if that makes any sense. That was definitely quite scary. But it's not looking bad so far. I do like how this is coming along. Let's see if we can try to get some landscaping down. Now, landscaping with this is going to be a little tricky because we are in a desert, so I would probably not go too lush, if that makes any sense. A lot of plants cannot tolerate the really extreme heat, or so I would think. Again, I'm not a botanist, I'm not a scientist, but I think it will limit realistically what we can place in here. And I'm gonna be stuck. I'm gonna be stuck, you guys, trying to figure out what the best option is. I'm trying to make a planter bed, but let's see. Maybe these have a good earthy quality. Okay, this is not bad. That's not a bad color to work with. So I'm thinking we do planter box there. I don't know if we do some turf. I'm gonna try to make a walkway. I think this is a really good way to bring in the lot. Let's see what we have to work with. We don't have terracotta. Do we have terracotta somewhere? Let's see. I think we have it in the floor tiles. Sometimes it's really stinky because I do want certain styles in either the brush form or in this form. But, you know, it doesn't always work out that way in The Sims. Sometimes you just don't have those options. But I think we'll try something like this. And I really want to explore what we have for the foliage. Okay, let's see. We do, like, some large cacti, as they're known. It's very confusing. I made that mistake a lot when I was young by calling them cactuses, but in the English language, they are cacti. And my goodness, don't get me started on the rules of English. I'm a native English speaker, and the rules just don't make sense, you guys. I feel like whoever was making English went rogue. They wanted to get creative, and it just made life hard for everybody. But yes, here are the cacti plants. To be honest with you guys, I don't know what a lot of the smaller plants are. I think of aloe vera, but I really don't think they are. Oh, they're agaves. Okay, pretty cool. But I know for a while, especially when I was in college, there was a huge phase where people were really into succulents. And it definitely was a thing. But you know what? I think I would have enjoyed succulents. They look like they're easier to take care of because I am absolutely terrible with plants, you guys. I think every single plant I've had has perished or maybe has come close to perishing. So you can definitely see the very terrible track record that I have. So I never encourage my family members to give me plants. If we do get plants, my partner is the one taking care of them because, yeah, it's terrible. My poor aunt, who is not with us anymore, unfortunately, we share that fate. We have, I guess we would call black thumbs or brown thumbs for people who are terrible with plants. I'm not really sure, but yeah, we're just very bad with them, unfortunately. But okay, we have a very nice little bit of landscaping here. I'm wondering if we can do something else, because this is a pretty big yard. Maybe we can add some nice fencing in. I do know the game has this one, Spanish Revival Wall, so I think... Whoa, where did this come from? Where did this come from, you guys? I totally selected the wrong thing. But I think it was a happy accident, because I do like that rustic feel, so maybe we can do cottage living. Maybe something like this. Is the house even centered? It's not really centered, is it? Okay, we're gonna shift it. We're gonna shift a little bit. I think we're off by one, right? Let's see. Okay, I think that's more or less what it was. But let's go ahead and do that. Maybe we'll extend it out here. Let's see. It's like, okay, here we go. We're gonna do some counting. One, two, maybe like that. One, two. I think that's about right. And we'll go all the way back. I feel like there's a more efficient way to measure this out, you guys, but I'm gonna be a simpleton. I'm just gonna count very carefully. So we can do that. We can kind of anchor it inside. Okay, which I think is fine. It gives it more of a ranch feel, which I think is really cool. But it's hard, you guys. I want to add trees, but trees just don't live. If I put a nice tree, it'll end up like this in a desert because it just can't stay alive. But maybe some of these palm trees, perhaps? Like some kind of palm tree. Again, I am not an expert on botany or plants, but I want to make sure that whatever is in here makes sense. But maybe something like this. I really love these from Island Living. It was really cool. They made like a variant of palm trees that lean. I think that's really interesting. So let's do that. Let me add a little bit of enclosure. If I can get that just right. Maybe something like this. I'm thinking actually a square, or perhaps it's fine like that. I'm not really sure, you guys. Let me try it again. Let me do like a bigger one. Bigger square and a little divot. I don't know, you guys. I don't think I'm gonna do it, actually. I think the palm trees are fine like there, just like that. Let me put in some rocks, perhaps, just get a little bit of terrain going. I totally forgot where the rocks are, you guys. I was so into these trees, and I totally forgot where the rocks are. But yes, here they are. We do have these nice snowy escape ones, but unfortunately, we have to be very careful with our packs here. I'm gonna have to keep track of the ones we are using. That's for sure. I do know we have cottage living. We have the jungle adventures pack. And what else? We're gonna play I Spy, you guys. We're gonna play some I Spy. Okay. Cottage living, jungle adventures, and okay. I'm gonna do us a favor, you guys. Unfortunately, I don't do kits. This was a one-time thing. I saw it was free. I went for it. I went back on my word and I got the kit. But we're gonna take out Desert Lux for now. So I think what we're gonna have to work with is island living, cottage living, and jungle adventures. I think that's a really good start. So let's keep with that. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to balance this out a little bit. This is a funny little tip I have, and again, it's a little bit of, I guess, a graphic designer's tip, if that makes any sense. But if you guys remember from art class, there are actually multiple kinds of symmetry, but with builds like this, I like to do a lot of asymmetrical balance to make the lot a little bit more realistic. So what I normally do with trees is on one side, I'll do two, and sometimes I'll vary the size. I think for this one, it's a little heavy on this side, so I'll just bop this guy. Ooh, he's too small. He's too small, you guys. But normally, I try to vary the size a little bit. I'll do two on one side and have one that's like large and small, and then the other tree being medium size. It doesn't quite work right now because I obviously don't have tool, but this tree doesn't have a lot of options. But I think this is pretty nice. So let's roll with that. I am a little weary of the walls here. They just don't match, you guys. They just don't match. Perhaps this one? Okay, this one matches a little better. Let me see if I can fix that foundation going in. And here, you know, guys, I have terrible memory. I'm gonna tell you guys that right now. There are so many areas of building in The Sims that I completely forget. I feel like I have a pretty decent eye for builds, but a lot of times when I'm building, there are features that I just completely forget where they are. I just clicked on that and hoped it was the foundation. So it's pretty bad sometimes, but we're gonna work with it. Anyways, we're gonna go on the inside now, and I think the outside is looking pretty good. I'm gonna try to figure out what we're gonna do up here because we do need a way to get out. This was what we had. Somebody peed. What do I do with that, you guys? somebody peed up there while I was renovating this house. I don't think I can delete this. Nope. Okay, we're gonna take care of that in the next episode. But here we are. Let me make some stairs in the inside. I think they actually got deleted, and I don't know if this is just a me problem, but unfortunately, I've been having that problem a lot. For some reason, the stairs just tend to delete on their own for some reason. Okay, these are too big. But yeah, it's a very strange occurrence, and I don't really know why it's happening. Maybe you guys can shed some light on that. But it happens a lot. I'm thinking perhaps I shift something and then it disappears. Something like that. It's very strange. But anyways, let me do this. I'm thinking we may be able to do the inside a little differently. Let me see if I can do maybe some simple lighting for now, just to see what I'm working with. But if we do have something better, I'm definitely going to go for it. Rustic ceiling lights, you guys. Rustic ceiling lights. I don't really know what kind of lighting this house would have. That's not good, you guys. I don't know what kind of lighting this place would have. There's this, if I want to do tiny living, but I don't really think that fits. Maybe something like this, like some drop lighting from the island living just for now. I may very likely change it, but we're going to do that for now. And I do want to restructure the inside too, because this area is very large. What I'm thinking we can do is actually create a smaller living room to the left. So what I'm going to do is just move these furniture pieces for now. I'm probably going to change them. I'm not like a huge fan of the base game furniture pieces, but I think we can definitely take care of that in a little bit. But I'm thinking we can separate this. This could be the living room here, and then over here will be the new dining room area. So it'll come off of the kitchen, and I think that'll be just fine. So let's do that. And for the walls, I'm not sure, you guys. This one's a little tricky. I could go more of a terracotta or a tile. I think like a tile would be really nice. Just a nice pop of color. But let's see what we have to work with. We have this one. Ooh, this one is pretty nice. I do enjoy this one quite a bit. I don't know if I'm gonna do it everywhere, but let me see if I can add it into the kitchen area. Because I do think I like how that looks. We probably have some new flooring options as well, and I'm even thinking of doing wood, perhaps, like a rustic wood for the bottom. We can stick with the... I'm not sure. I'm not sure, you guys. We have warmer tone. I don't know, you guys. I'm not sure about this. Maybe I'll stick with the terracotta for now because I think that's better fitting. Let's see if we have more options, though. That's pretty interesting. I don't mind this too much. It's definitely a busier motif. Ooh, maybe this one. Oh my gosh, you guys. I'm gonna be here for a while. I'm going through all these options trying to figure out what works best. But perhaps we can try this one. I like that it has a little bit more intrigue, I think. It has a little bit more intrigue than the others. But we might see how certain things work out. Let me see if I can put it in here. Take a look. I don't know. We're going to have a part two to this, so if you guys have ideas, if you guys have suggestions on which ones I should use, definitely let me know, but maybe I'll try this one for now. There is a chance that if this series goes long, I will do like another component where I pretty much like advance forward so you guys can see more of the design. Because I'm slow, you guys. I'm going to be honest. I'm a very slow builder. I think the problem is I'm just very picky with things. So I go back and forth a lot. Hopefully I'm not the only one that has this issue, but yes, that is what I run into. But here we are, we're gonna try and resolve this bathroom situation. We couldn't even get in last time, but I'm thinking I can block it out perhaps over here, like kind of along the wall. And that should give us more room for the bedroom itself. We could even sample, let's see. Could sample the wall outside. There's the puddle, you guys. I'm gonna have to take care of that. But for now, let's see. Probably do a half wall over here. Be a little bit taller. Okay. Don't think that's too bad. Again, I'm gonna have to take care of that puddle, but let me clear out this area so we have a fresh, clean slate. Because yeah, this bathroom, guys, it was not working. It was not working at all. But okay, let's reuse some of these windows. I may change them again, depending on how things go. But I do want to go back down here and sample this lovely tile. I think it's really beautiful, and I may try to use it in other places. Perhaps even here, let's see. Can we just go everywhere? Is it weird if I just put it everywhere? We do have this one. This one's pretty nice too. Maybe we'll have to be choice about it. You know what I mean? Like just enough in the right places. Cause we do have a nice orange. Oh, they're all orange. Okay. I don't know, you guys. I'm really not sure. Let me keep it in these two areas. I don't want to make it too busy, but we'll have the bathroom there, and maybe we'll do a sliding door. This door is really cool, but it, yeah, I think it's a little bit much. It's a little bit much for this build. So we're going to hold off on that. There is this door. It doesn't quite fit. Let me see if we can do these doors. This could be pretty interesting, but I have to think of where the bed's going to situate. I think the bed will situate right here. So let me put the doors here and then move the window over here. Okay, that's not bad. I think that's pretty nice. We can match it. Great. So we do have that. Let me see if we can put this awning up here as well. And that's about right. It's a little weird, you guys. The hinges of it kind of go into the window, but I don't think it's a deal breaker. Let me know. Maybe perhaps it is, but I think it fits in quite well. So I do like this a lot more. I'm just going to go in and perhaps add a few lounge chairs just to get that vibe going. And yeah, let's see. We have these really... Ooh, I like this. I like this a lot. These are really great chairs, again, from the Jungle Adventures pack. Let me see if they have other options for colors. That's really cool. I do like this pop a lot, but let's try it like this. Can we keep that blue? There is that nice teal connection. I dig that. I dig the teal connection, you guys. So maybe we'll keep this. Let me see if there's just one more. Ooh. I like this, you guys. I like this a lot. So maybe we'll do this. Let's try to get a nice rug going on. And let's see. We do have the rugs from Jungle Adventures again. Maybe we'll try something like this. I think it's a little loud for my taste, so let's see if we can tone it down. That is pretty cool. I like that it's neutral, but it lets the chairs shine, which is nice. And I do have an end table in mind, so let's see. Actually, not an end table, you guys, coffee table. So let's see if we can get that going. There is this one, but I think... Is it too nice for the outside, guys? Sometimes I'm really not sure. But let's do perhaps this one. Nice round table. It does have an interesting motif. It does look very handmade. Maybe something like this. That would be pretty cool. I would want to get more plants. So I'm going to actually go into Show All, and I'm going to filter by Jungle Adventures because they had this really beautiful set of ceramic pots, and I think they'll look great outside. Is it this one? Yes, these look really cool. But where to put them? Where to put them, you guys? I wanted them next to the chairs, but alas. Let's see. Perhaps we can rotate this. Get this going. Have a nice little... It almost looks like we could have a cookout here. I think that could be really cool also if we can get something like that going on. But yeah, these... I love these pots, you guys, but they're fitting so weirdly. Sims 4, why did you put them all in together? Why did you put them all in one? So maybe we can get them separately, maybe something like this instead. We're gonna separate it a little bit. We do like a nice pot. Okay, I think they did separate them. I spoke too soon, you guys. I spoke too soon. That is what I get. But we have a little bit of that going on. Let me put the chairs closer together. I do want to make sure that your Sims can use them, though. So I think this should be enough clearance. Let's take a look at night. These little lamps actually are not working too badly. So maybe we'll use some of these just along the wall a little bit. And then maybe some candles on the outside. I think that could be really cool. Perhaps on the little table. Let's see what we have here. And... overwhelmed with options. That's the first thing. I don't know if you guys feel the same way, but that's definitely how I feel sometimes. And I don't even have all the packs, but yes, it is very overwhelming sometimes. I'm thinking these candles could be nice. There's also the one from Island Living, but it's a little too themed towards the islands. So perhaps we'll do this one. I love the motifs on these. I think they're really nice. So we have that going on, and I think this is a really good stopping point. We're going to continue working on finessing the outside and getting more into the inside as well, while I fix a lot of the problems that this lot had previously. But I don't know about you guys, but I am definitely enjoying this a lot more. And as the first component of this renovation series, please let me know if you guys enjoyed this. I think it's very fun and chill. It's a little longer. It's a little on the longer side. But I'm thinking if you enjoy simmers like Devon Bumpkin, who does a really good job of real-time builds, hopefully you guys enjoy this component as well. And as promised, this is going to be a limited pack build. And once I get through all of the renovation components for said build, you guys will be able to use and download this lot as well, just like all the normal builds that I do. And all right, guys, this is the Pueblo house so far. Again, I'm thinking it's looking so much better, and I hope I see you guys in the next build renovation component of the Pueblo house. So with that, as usual, this is TownieSimBuilds signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.